My dear child, no, nothing is wrong. I just want to be alone.
Papa, why are you still asleep? Dariola, what is going on? Is there anything the matter?
I don't know. I'm just trying to find out what the matter is. Papa said he just wants to be alone.
My children, it's okay. I'm only thinking of something, Toriola.
Yes, Papa.
Go and wake any Ethan.
Papa, is any Ethan matter?
No.
Okay.
So, Papa, what have you been thinking that makes you awake at this time of the night?
I have been thinking about the incense misfortune. Befalling this kingdom, my subject, my reign, princess, my wife, your mother, who left from this sacred forest and never returned. Of course, my children, I have been thinking of how to ensure you for a secured and protected tomorrow, but I can't put my finger on anything.
That is kind of you, Papa.
Thank you, my princess. Adelani?
Yes, Papa.
Eniton?
Yes, Papa.
Toriola?
Yes, Papa.
There is something you should know. I can never tell. I might sleep and fail to rise at dawn.
Papa, not read again.
Yes. The older a man grows, the closer he is to death.
Papa, why are you talking like this? Must you talk about death?
No. Neither have I a premonition of death. But what must be said must be said.
Then, what are you thinking about? Are you trying to scare us?
My children, death is inevitable. So as a man grows older, the more once in a while thinks of death, so that he can ensure to place some things placeable to avoid inheritance and tussle of the family thereafter.
Oh, Papa, is this to share your wealth and properties after all?
No, that is not why I have called you here tonight. There is nothing to share my properties, riches, for it has been mortgaged.
Eh? How?
It's a long, sad story. It's no gainsaying. I am a wealthy man, a businessman, in the nook of the crane of the kingdom, before I became king. We are all living happily and comfortable, but someone was not contented. Maybe your mother or I. She suddenly mounted pressure on me, that she wanted power to addition to wealth. That led to the kingship of the throne. We lost the peace and the joy, including you. We almost lost you, Eniton.
Me? How?
When your mother Ashake was pregnant, the oracle demanded that anyone at that period who give birth to any child should offer the child for the sacrifice. But it was you, Eniton, we give birth to. And we couldn't afford to give you up. So we opt for an alternative. Your mother was told to carry the sacrifice to the forest of Igbo Arimabo, where she left and never returned.
Oh, Mama. This is how we lost you.
That is how we lost your mother, Ashake. But something frightened me.
What is that, Papa?
If peradventure I die now, my son, Eniton, will become king. I foresee problem.
Papa, you will not die.
Ashe!
By the special might of Olodumare, the creator of all century, you will never die.
Ashe!
You will see us going higher in this life.
Ashe!
Ododo, the Ododo that I cherish so much, B
beautiful in the morning dew, still beautiful in the daytime, giving joy and hope to the world of food to come. Ashe, Adelani, where are you going to with this?
Adelete Kingdom.
Adelete Kingdom? That far away kingdom. To do what?
Papa, I want to go and carve a niche for myself.
A niche for yourself?
Yes, Papa.
Okay, if that may be the case, then I must accompany you a royal company.
Papa, where is my sister going? Adelani?
Adelani? She has gone to find her way and wait for life experience.
Ah, why?
For her to be a successful woman.
Papa, I, Edith, I would never leave you or this royal household for anywhere.
Why?
Because the comfort and safety of the royal household is enough to make me a successful woman I want to be.
Anything.
Papa.
Let the kid in you grow.
Stop me from entering the palace earlier.
Why?
I wouldn't understand.
Well, he might be trying to test his mettle of authority.
Test his mettle of authority on me, Ajiroba.
Of course, Ajiroba, look, everybody likes to test his or her mettle of authority, no matter how lowly placed.
Papa?
Anything?
Here's your food, Papa.
Put it down. My son.
Papa.
You can go.
Yes, sir.
Ajiroba.
Habisi.
There's something I want to tell you.
What could that be, Habisi?
About my reign, my kingdom, how it has not been peaceful. It has been full of calamities, now and then. A king by inclination, it has been worse. I wonder why this happened in my own reign.
Habisi, everything will be alright. Just eat your food. It's getting cold. It's getting cold.
Ah, Ajiroba, I'm feeling uncomfortable. My stomach!
Habisi.
Ah!
Habisi. Habisi, what is wrong with you?
Habisi,
don't do this. Habisi, what is this?
Ajiroba!
Habisi, I don't know. I don't know. I didn't do anything to him. I don't know.
Habisi! Habisi!
What is happening over here?
Ajiroba, what did you do to the king?
I don't do anything.
What is happening over here?
I don't know
anything. Habisi! Habisi!
Habisi!
Come here, sister.
I greet you all.
We greet you too.
The councils of chiefs have called you all here to tell you our findings in presence of the king's death. Now, let's listen to the mouth of our forefathers.
I bring greetings from our forefathers.
We greet them.
After series of investigation with the councils of chiefs and consultation with the oracle, we discovered that this man over there, Ajiroba, killed the king.
Ah!
Yes, he killed the king. Poisoning.
No, I did not. I did nothing to the king. Please.
You
please.
Did. And by the tradition of Adigbo Kingdom, whosoever done what you have done before seven sunset, he must be adjudged guilty at the village square and sentenced to death.
Yes, he must pay the price.
Please do not judge me guilty of a crime
shut
I did not
commit. You must be stupid.
By the power confided on me, by our tradition, and by the castles of chiefs,
you are judged guilty. Adigbo must be sentenced to death.
Please, please do not sentence me to death. I know nothing about this. Please.
Warrior!
Yes, my lord.
Take him to the sacred forest. Ibrahim Abo. And bring back his head before the sun sets.
Okay, Lua.
Baba!
Who is that?
Baba Fagu! It's I, Princess Toriola!
Ah! Ah! Princess! Princess Toriola!
Baba!
What is the matter?
Baba!
Why are you crying?
Baba, I'm leaving Ijagun Kingdom.
Leaving Ijagun Kingdom?
Yes,
why?
Baba.
And what for?
Baba, they are threatening.
Threatening? By whom?
By my younger brother, Anitan, Ifa Priest.
Ifa Priest?
Yes, Baba. Ever since my father had the accident, Baba, the father has been taking pleasures on me. He said I must marry him whether I like it or not.
He must be joking.
Baba, he means it so. He means it from his words. He said my late mother, Olori Asake, has given me to him for marriage. In an exchange of a favor.
What favor?
Baba, I don't know. He said he has revealed his own vow.
To hell with his vow and his favor. But that is not enough reason for you to leave your father's kingdom.
Baba, yeah, you poor. Baba, I can't stand it. I can't stand this emotional trauma. I can't stand it. I can't tolerate the elders and the leaders of this kingdom again.
How do you mean?
Ajoba was an expected husband. They killed him for a crime. I'm very sure he was never committed.
Oh, I see.
Baba, Baba, try to understand. We are worried to leave this kingdom. Wherever my late mother, Lori Asake and Kavi is here, they will forever appreciate your concern and love and understanding over me. Baba, please, please, Baba, try to understand. Baba, Odigba, Odigba, Baba, Odabo.
I welcome you all to this memorable event. The coronation ceremony of Editor of Olagbade. Now, I hand over the affair to you. If I please.
If I be all.
Ashe.
Oba lawa jelo ni o.
Bene.
Eja ashe bi won tin se. Ko ba le bi ati fe ko ri o.
Bene.
Editor, o ma kin gbadi Olagbade. Ki gba re ko so wa si mi o.
Ashe. Ashe.
Anything, step forward. You have to make a choice out of these three calabashes. And whatsoever you make now will determine how your future will look like.
Balogun Ogido Apeno Adivala. What next?
Any term of the crown. Apeno, over to you.
What I should put here, can't shake only by you, but you're going.
Baby!
Any term, I'm going to go lucky by go to Alarao. Now, people of Ajogun Kingdom, I present to you the new king of Ajogun.
Yes.
Emi la o ni ni
Good day, yes.
Good day, who is it?
It's I, Apagun.
Apagun, come right in.
How are you? I'm fine, and you?
I'm fine too.
Don't be surprised. I have come to see you.
Come to see me? That call for celebration. So, what should I offer you?
You may not have what I want.
Tell me what you want.
A pure white chair to sit on.
Is that all?
Nothing more.
Give me a minute. Apagun, here is your demand.
Adifala, this chair is thin.
Thin?
It is thin and it sinks of blood.
Apagun, you must be driving at something.
You said it.
So, what is it?
I have come to tell you that we all know that over this past year, you are the major cause of the calamities and tragedies befalling our kingdom. The late Olaniyan Aanuoluwapo inspired you with her husband's words, and you conspired with her and make her late husband king instead of the Ijagun affairs, my family.
I see.
Your unselfish human attitude caused that king his death, and the blood of that young innocent man, Ajiroba, is on your hands.
You better mind your dirty words. Otherwise.
Otherwise, what? I, Apagun Potter of this kingdom, will never be afraid or threatened by your evil deeds. And let me tell you something, you will never go unpunished in this land of equity. Good day.
It is you I have come to see, Ibadola.
Papa,
how have I got that issue to discuss with you?
At midnight.
Yes, this is the best time to discuss such issues. My veil is green. There is grass every here and here. It is 17 years now since my father, King Akimbadi, died and I've been made king. There has never been peace on this land. My subjects are dying. And you know how much I cherish them so much. And you know I love you too.
Yes, sir. But what do you want us to do now?
Iwa, the gods have spoken. He said they want my daughter to bear the sacrifice to the sacred forest.
Your daughter, you say?
Yes.
The sacred forest?
Yes.
The one which grandma went and never came back.
Iwa, I want you to know you are a woman with a lion heart. With your disposition in this land, will you sit back and watch my people die?
No, but...
May you go and come back safely.
What if I may not return, Papa?
Ibadola, the gods have spoken.
Long may you reign, my king. My people, we are ready to support the princess to carry the sacrifice to the forest. If our priest, are we set?
Yes, we are set.
Kabiesi, yes, we are set.
Go and get her.
Kabiesi, can't you ask the oracle if there is an alternative? Apagun, it's not time for questioning.
There is no alternative. The gods have spoken. The fact is,
Your Highness,
where is the sacrifice?
Here it is, Your Highness.
Give it to her.
Yeah. At this point.
Why?
Because the tradition and custom of this land forbids us.
Oh, God, has anyone ever gone to this place and ever came back?
No, it has never happened before.
What do I do now?
Go, let your character lead you, and may the creator go with you.
I greet you, people of Ajogbo Kingdom.
We greet you too.
I greet you once again, people of Ajogbo Kingdom.
We greet you too.
I have summoned every one of you here to see the face of a deceitful elder. An elder who is supposed to see to the security of the kingdom. But all he's looking for is the death of me, King of Ajogbo Kingdom. Yes! He wants me dead because he wants his son, King, after me. This is him. This is the face of the saboteur. This is him.
I am not a saboteur.
You are.
And if there is anyone here, may he never see the day sunset.
My people, as tradition and law demands, anyone who kills or plans the death of his neighbor shall never be spared. No matter how high placed he is, he shall face the wrath of the law.
People of Ajogbo Kingdom, joy will it bring to you when an innocent man is killed?
The amount of his sermon cannot change my mind. I have decided and I have decided. People of Adebo Kingdom, whoa, you will take this man to the sacred forest and he will come back with nothing but his head. Arise.
King Enito.
Iwa.
Yes, it is Iwa. I'm still alive.
You're welcome.
I thank you. I really appreciate your love and concern.
You're welcome.
May we all never fall victim of circumstances we answer for our enemy.
Ashe.
My people, the deed of a man is like a pregnancy, which cannot be hidden. No matter how long, the fruit of the deed accordingly will surely come to manifestation. Neither good or bad, like the two sides of an ox spring from the womb. The deed of King Enito, my father, are incredible. Yes, before I tell the atrocities committed by King Enito, I will have to seek forgiveness from Eledua, good people of Ajogbo Kingdom. My brief sojourn to the sacred forest, Igwaremabo, was a deliberate plan by my father to kill me. Yes, he wants me dead because of my affection for Oyekon, the son of Apagun. The person who killed King Akibade is still existing and is standing right here with us.
Who is the person?
The person killed him by poisoning his food, and the person is... He killed his own father, King Akibade. Let no man judge him. Let's hear what he has to say. Let's look into the judgment of Elijah.
But he's nowhere to be found.
Let one of his chiefs go in and talk him out.
Our king is dead. He commits suicide.
The Ifa priest must not be spared. He must not run away.
The cast and in general location.
The experience so far was good.
For the money they gave to me during the time of production, because I thank God, because I was the second person to pay. Make it entertainment.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The experience.
Let me just thank God at first. Though it is not easy.
My name is Abdusalam Abiola Ridwan.
Oh, thank you. And what cast you the role of?
I play the role of Apagun in the film titled The King of Our Time.
And how was it?
Well, bless God, it has been wonderful. It was cool, and though it was stressful, we bless the Almighty God. And we thank our lecturers, Dr. Idowu and Dr. Oriola. They are the one in charge of this film production. I bless them.